up guys, Sal here. So XDA developers has found code in Samsung system app for biometric security that suggests Samsung will introduce something called a time of flight sensor. For those of you who don't know, time of flight sensor is a method for measuring the distance between a sensor and an object based on the time difference between the emission of a signal and its return to the sensor after being reflected by an object.
Does that mean?
In simple terms, it's a 3D scanner just like Apple's TrueDepth system, but works differently. So how's this different from Apple's Face ID? Well, Apple uses dot projection to scan the face. It blasts the face with thousands of tiny dots to create a detailed 3D map. The reason the notch on the iPhone X or XS is so big is because of these sensors. For Face ID to work, Apple need dot projector, infrared camera, flood illuminator, and proximity sensor. While this time of flight sensor doesn't require all of these, it's a more simple tech since it uses a single pulse of light. So yeah, companies who uses this technology won't require to have such a big space up there at the top of the display. Of course, that said, the 5G Galaxy S10 will surely have this tech on board. It's expected to have it at both the front and back. Now, the question is, will the Galaxy S10 Plus also have this tech since it will have two cameras at front? We still don't know what's that second camera is gonna be. Is it a normal camera lens or this time of flight sensor? I guess we'll find out soon as the device is rumored to go official on 20th of February. So a lot of you guys were asking me over the past few days if the Galaxy S10 will use graphene batteries. I don't know where you guys heard this rumor, but it's not true. The Galaxy S10 for sure won't have graphene batteries. This new battery tech is revolutionary, which still isn't ready for commercialization yet. So yeah, don't expect it so soon. Samsung will showcase their sound on display tech at CES in January. Samsung might showcase these sound on display OLED panels for both smartphones and TVs. The company provided a few details about this tech at the Samsung OLED Forum conference in China a couple of months ago. By using this technology, companies can eliminate the top speaker, which will result in more screen-to-body ratio. The sound comes through the display, and it will be clear and loud, just like the normal speaker. By the way, the Galaxy S10 most likely won't have this tech if the leaked screen protector is anything to go by. That being said, please consider subscribing for all the Galaxy S10 updates, and as always, I'll see y'all tomorrow. Peace out.